Hello and welcome to this tutorial on cleaning up a mesh for use in a game engine. Now, a lot of times when you bring in a model that is made in some AutoCAD program like Inventor or SolidWorks or a spline modeling program like Rhino, you get a problem where the mesh isn't as clean as it should be, and you end up with a lot of extra vertices, a lot of extra polygons, a lot of extra edges. For example, if you look at these two objects in this demo scene, they both look fine on the surface. But if we go into edit mode, you can see that the meshes are fairly messy and there's a lot of extra stuff that doesn't need to be there. So in this first part of this tutorial, I will be going over some basic terminology I'm going to be using a lot through the rest of this tutorial, as well as some basic techniques. So if we jump over to this mesh on the left here and I go up a little bit, a perfect mesh is theoretically a grid. Just a grid of quads, and it wraps into the shape that makes up the model. However, this isn't always possible, but we can get close. For example, if we use our imagination here, I'm going to break out the grease pencil and draw some lines. We can sort of see that there is an underlying grid here. And while there's a little bit of area over here in the upper right that doesn't make up a grid, we can still use this as a starting point. So if I go down to the edge select tool down here and select it, I'm going to select all the edges that do not make up that grid. Now I'm not going to select the two edges on the top left and bottom right corner. This is because that when edges terminate in a corner, if we delete them, they can cause some issues, which I will show you in just a second. So if we hit X on these selected edges and go down to dissolve edges, the edges just vanish and we don't have to worry about them anymore. Now, the reason I said we don't want to delete these edges is because if an edge terminates in a corner and we dissolve it, it'll clip the corner and we don't want that. So in order to fix it, what we have to do is we have to hit X, delete only edges and faces, and then we can select two of these edges and hit F on our keyboard to bridge the gap. And we can do it with the other one as well. So X, only edges and faces, select two, and then hit F. So if we go over here to this corner, we can see that this doesn't fit into our perfect grid idea. And if we go ahead and dissolve these edges, you can see it creates the problem where it clips the edges just like before. So what we are going to have to end up doing is we are going to have to do the same thing. X, delete only edges and faces, and then we can go ahead and in vertex select mode, we can select these two, W, subdivide to give us that extra vertice here, and then we can go ahead and select these four vertices and make faces. Now, sometimes when you dissolve edges, it'll leave extra vertices here that are very important to pay attention to. And we can just go ahead and dissolve that one and go ahead and face that off. And now we have a perfect grid. However, meshes aren't always this easy. A lot of the times you have a lot of faces that you need to get rid of all at once, and it can be a real pain to select every single one individually. In order for us to help with this, I'm going to go up to File, User Preferences, and I'm going to search for loop tools under the add-ons and make sure loop tools is selected. This is a very helpful add-on that is going to make cleaning up meshes a ton easier. So if I go into top view, what we can do is we can look and we can see that there are a lot of parallel edges here and we can use those to our advantage. First off, I'm going to select these edges. So I'm going to hit C to bring up the brush select and then left mouse select a giant strip of polygons. And then I'm going to use middle mouse to deselect the ones I don't want. So with this strip of polygons selected, what we can see is there's a lot of parallel edges here. So if I break out the handy grease pencil again, you can see that every vertice on the top has a matching vertice on the bottom. So that means we can use something called the bridge tool. So with this strip selected, I can X, faces, and then I can go ahead, alt select this edge, shift alt select the other edge, and then middle mouse to deselect the edges we don't want, and then W, loop tools, bridge. And it'll go ahead and bridge any gaps in the mesh for us. And we can use that for the rest of the mesh up at the top. So I want to take it one strip at a time so we don't lose the actual form of the mesh. So I can hit X, faces, Alt, Shift, Select, W, bridge. And now we run into a problem. In cases where the mesh butts up against a hard edge like this, we can't delete these faces without destroying the shape of the mesh. If I go ahead and delete these, we have no record of where that edge once was. So my trick for handling this is to select the edge using C and the brush select tool, and then middle mouse deselecting the ones we don't want, and then hitting Shift D, and that'll duplicate the edge, and then escape. And what that'll do is that'll duplicate the edge, but it'll leave it in the same exact spot as the other edge. So that way, we can go back into face select, use our brush select to select all those faces, and hit X and delete faces. And we still have that edge that's just floating there that we can use to Alt, Shift, Select, W, Loop Tools, Bridge. And now we have that edge back, except now instead of all those ugly triangles, it's now very clean. But that leaves one more case, which is this front edge of this mesh. Now, we have a problem here. If I go to this small area of the mesh, you can see that we have our imaginary grid right here where everything lines up, but we also have these edges down here where there's an edge on the bottom, but there's nothing on the top to connect it to. So in cases like these, we have a choice. We can either go through and using Control R or the knife tool with K, we can go through and add in edges manually. But in a game engine, adding extra geometry isn't usually the preferred option. So instead, I'm going to remove the edges on the bottom. So I'm going to delete these grease pencil layers, and I'm going to go ahead and in face select, select this whole strip right here, deselect the ones we don't want, and I'm just going to go ahead and delete that to make it easier. But now we can go ahead and we can manually select every other edge if we want, but that is a huge pain, especially if we had like 1,000 edges on a huge mesh that we need to do all at once. That's going to take you forever. So instead, we are going to hit C to use brush select, select all those edges on the bottom, and then I'm going to hit space to bring up the search box and search for checker deselect. And with some options, it allows to select every other edge. Or if we go down to the options, we can select every third edge or fourth edge, but I'm going to leave this at 2. And then I'm going to set the offset to 1. That way it selects the edges we don't need. And I'm going to X, dissolve edges. And now I can simply hit Alt, Shift, Select, W, Loop Tools, Bridge. And now we have 2 clean meshes that are ready for import into a game object. Next, I'm going to jump over to the actual mesh and we will get started. Okay, now that we're looking at our actual model, we can see if we go into edit mode that whatever software was used to create this model has left us a lot of extra geometry and triangles that we need to clean up if we want to bring this into a game engine. Now, I want to stress that for every single model you're working on, this process is going to be very different. However, there are a few simple techniques that we can use to minimize our workload that across all models. However, a lot of what you're going to be doing is going to be based on intuition and just trying to use your imagination to figure out how the mesh should be. So the first one of these steps that I want to show you is look for symmetry. So right down the middle here, we can see that there is a big line where the model is split down the middle. And if we look at the back of it, we can see that there's some geometry that doesn't quite match up, like up here, where there's no line, but we can fix that later. In fact, we're gonna end up deleting most of that geometry anyways up top, so we won't have to worry about that. So I'm gonna go into the front of this model. I'm going to make sure that limit selection to visible is turned off. And then in vertex select mode, I'm gonna hit B to bring up box select and select everything on the left side. Technically, you could select everything on the right side too, but I prefer working on the right side. So you're gonna hit X, and you're going to delete faces. And because there's a lot of triangles and overlapping geometry, you're going to have some geometry and some vertices left over. So just select those and hit X, delete vertices. And now we are going to add a mirror modifier. And with this model, I have to mirror over the Z-axis because the rotation's a little off. Now you can see that we have what looks like our original model, but if we go into edit mode, there's a lot less geometry to work with. And just as on a side note, you're going to want to turn on clipping because that's going to make our job a lot easier. Next thing we want to do is we want to hit A to select all our mesh, hit spacebar to bring up the search bar, and we are going to type in tries to quads and hit enter. And what that's going to do, if I look at this bevel right here and undo it, you can see that it's already cleaned up a lot of the really simple to clean up geometry and has saved us a lot of work. And the third thing that we're going to want to do is we're going to want to look at flat faces. Because, for example, if I take these faces right here, I can just completely ignore all these faces. I don't care about the geometry. I can X faces, delete them. And then later, I can simply select these edges and then extrude on the Y-axis and just bring them together and it'll automatically be quads. So we want to look for flat faces. I'm going to leave that face for now. Right now, what I'm focused on are these faces right here. Actually, before we do that, one more thing. Select your entire mesh and hit W, remove doubles. And I'm going to shade it flat because that just made the model look ugly. And this model has auto smooth turned on, so I'm going to turn off auto smooth as well. This model is not mine. It was provided to me by somebody else, so I am working on this for the first time as you are. Again, first thing we're going to do is we're going to delete flat faces. So this is a big flat face on this side of the object. I'm going to delete this entire area because it's going to make cleaning up the edges a lot easier. So I'm going to delete these faces. I'm going to go to the back. I'm going to delete those faces as well. Careful on this model to not select the bevel around the edge, but select these little faces in here as well. Okay, delete those. And now you can see the inside of this is flat as well. And it's leaving some weird geometry in here that we're not even gonna see. So I'm gonna just delete those faces and I'm gonna delete all the inside faces. I'm going to delete these faces as well. Because again, it's as easy as later. All we have to do is select these edges like this and extrude on the Y-axis and everything will be brought together just like it was before. And I'm going to do the same on the front faces right here. And I'm going to leave these flat faces on the inside because we will work on those later. But now I'm going to choose my entry point, which is where to start actually working on this model. And I think the best place to do that would be right here on the bottom. So if I break out the grease pencil and start using my imagination, I can sort of imagine a rectangle right here. And that's confirmed to be the correct geometry for this mesh, because as you can see right below it, there is another perfect rectangle down here. So that's going to be our starting point for our mesh. So I'm going to go into edge select. I'm going to select these and dissolve those, dissolve edges. And I'm going to make my way around the model from front to back. Simply deleting the edges we do not need. Normally I would use bridge in a case like this, but because it's butting up against the mirror axis, it's going to cause problems for us. But now it's not. Now we can simply go into our side view here, turn off the limit visible to selected, and select all these faces on the inside. Actually, it's probably better to use it. So I can just select these faces. Whoops. Deselect those, select these, X faces. And now all I have to do is go into vertex select and dissolve the unnecessary edges. Dissolve vertices, my bad. And now, if this is correct, these two, whoops. If you ever get a weird thing like this where you try to select an edge using Alt and right select, most of the time it's due to a loose vertex. So if we go into vertex select, as you can see, just like I expected, there is a loose vertex there that we don't want. So we're gonna X dissolve vertices. And now we should be able to Alt, Shift, select these two, W, loop tools, bridge. And after you bridge, you always wanna inspect it for triangles. Because sometimes you'll get a weird thing where like the mesh will come across like this after you bridge it. And that is because there are too many vertices on this side and not enough on this side. So I'm just going to undo that and continue to clean this mesh. Now, unfortunately, on this edge, or on this beveled area right down here, we are running into a problem where there's a lot of geometry on the right side and not enough on the left side. So we just kind of have to make the choice ourselves what we want to keep. And unfortunately, no matter how we do this, it's going to look a little messy. But what we can do when there are like sharp edges like this right here, where there's a big corner, is we can select a vertice and double tap G, and that'll allow us to slide the edge along the edge and just kind of make the mesh a little more relaxed so it doesn't look quite as jagged. However, on this one, as we can see, there is a perfect line going across and then it terminates in this weird V shape right here. So I'm going to hit K for the knife tool, make a line straight across there, and then dissolve the edges around that. So dissolve edges, dissolve this edge, dissolve this edge. And that seems to be the pattern for the rest of the way up. So I'm gonna cut, dissolve edges. Now we have a kind of messy area up here, so I'm just not even going to bother with dissolving the edges, and I'm going to use bridge again. So I'm going to go into face select, select these faces, faces, not dissolve. Yeah, that's what we want to do. We want to delete all these. I'm going to even this off a little bit just by double tapping G and bringing this down. And then if we bridge this, you'll notice that it creates some triangles here. That is because there are not enough vertices on the top, or too many vertices on top and not enough on the bottom. So I'm going to undo that and eliminate some of these vertices that we have. So I'm gonna eliminate that one and that one, dissolve them, dissolve this one. I'm trying to pick the ones that are resulting in a triangle, although that one obviously connects to one on the bottom. I'm gonna dissolve that one. And now I'm gonna try again, W loop tools bridge. Nope. So I'm gonna dissolve this one. Try again, loop tools bridge. And that worked, but it's a little messy. So let's clean this up by double tapping G and sliding these edges along, making it a little cleaner. And that looks a little better. But now we have this big old expanse up here, which we're not going to by any means dissolve the edges. So we're gonna use bridge again. We're just gonna select all this. X faces. And then we are going to go ahead and dissolve the extra vertices. and attempt to bridge. And it looks like I got a successful bridge on my first try. Awesome. I didn't leave any vertices behind, so that's good. So as you can see, this whole edge, if we just alt-right click that, we can select that entire edge. And same thing with this one, and just dissolve those. And then go ahead and connect the weird diamond shape. I don't know why, but there's a lot of weird diamond shapes on this model that we can just connect like that. As a matter of fact, I'm gonna go ahead and dissolve all of these. Except that one, that's where it stops. So dissolve those. And I'm only dissolving the diamonds that do not connect in an edge. So if you see, this diamond connects in an edge, yet the one I just deleted does not connect in an edge. Actually, I need to connect that with the knife tool first. So connect with the knife tool. And when you're using the knife tool across a bunch of different faces, there are two ways you can do it. You can either hit K, or either align your viewport so you're facing it head on. That way you make a straight line. Or else if you don't, for example, if I'm facing down here, and I hit K and cut across, it's going to cut this weird curved line, and we don't want that. So you can either align your viewport with the edge, or you can hit K and control, and hold control, and that will make sure that the dots are always in the center. Now, when you come across a place like this where there's no, where we're going to need an edge across here, make this cut first, and then make, then make the vertical cut. And now we're getting in some really messy territory where I think it would be more beneficial if we just deleted huge chunks at a time. So I'm gonna delete this big strip here because I see potential where we can bridge this later. So I'm gonna X, delete faces. And then I'm going to do the same with little bits down here. So I'm gonna go like this, X faces, and then dissolve the vertices we don't need. Bridge. And if we ever realize that later we do need geometry, it's as simple as hitting Control R, adding an edge loop, and then positioning this where we need to. Oops. Undid a little too far there. Okay, and now because this edge right here connects with this edge, we are going to have to start working on one side or the other. And right now, I think it would be easier to start working on this area down here, because that is going to move up into the main body of the mesh and really determine how our topology flows. So let's see. I'm going to dissolve these vertices. Oops, no, I'm not. I'm going to dissolve this edge. It's always usually better to dissolve an edge and not a vertice. In almost every case. Dissolving these ones on the side, and you can see that this is easily forming all quads. Now, when you reach a point like this, where there is a dividing line, this edge, because, I don't know, it's hard to see probably with this model, but this whole area down here is This whole area down here is slightly curved. So edges like this help actually hold the position front and back, so we need those. But we want those to be quads. So the easy way to do it is to hit K to bring up the knife tool and simply make a slice across there whenever we come across something like this. And then we can select the edges we don't need and dissolve them. Now, unfortunately, you can tell we are losing a little bit of form here. I'm actually going to delete that last one. It's good to make these cuts before you dissolve the faces, or dissolve the edges, which I haven't been doing, but I will be doing from now on. So make the cut first, and then dissolve the edges below it. This way we keep as much of that original form as possible, and everything matches up still. So in this case, we make a cut across. Now this is another flat face right here, so we're just going to delete that. And an easy way to make sure you've gotten rid of all the triangles is to hit Control R and see if that purple line to make an edge loop follows all the way around. So as you can see, if we do it vertically, the purple line goes all the way up and then it stops up here at that triangle. That means we've hit a triangle. So like here, if I hit Control R, you can see that that edge does not wrap around all the way because we have this phantom vertex right here. And we have another phantom vertex down here. But that should be it. I'm just thankful there is no back face to this area, because that would just make it that much harder. And in fact, I'm going to turn off mirror. I'm going to go over here and hit the little eyeball. That way, we can see the inside of our model a little better. So delete that face. Actually, I'm just going to delete this vertex, because if we look at the actual original model, which I'm not going to open right now. I'll probably put up an overlay or something right here. But we're not going to be able to see this model in-game, and that's where this is going. It's going in-game. So we just want to remove everything that we're not going to see. I think it'd be best if we just merge these two. So merge at last. Now, there are going to be triangles in any hard surface. It's unavoidable. But we can simply do our best to try and avoid it. And you know what? This whole interface right here is just going to cause us more problems than it's worth. And if we look at the front view, this edge right here lines up with an edge on the inside, so it'll be easy to match it up later. So what we can do is we can just delete all these faces and extrude into the center later, and that'll make our job a lot easier. So X faces. Ugh. Okay, so this is leaving behind a lot of phantom geometry. So like here, faces. If we go into vertex select, you can see there's a vertex right here that we can just delete. There's an entire edge here we can just delete. And I'm deleting these edges. I'm not dissolving these edges. Again, it's hard to see, but there are vertices hanging here, kind of in the midair. So I'm going to delete those. Okay, and that should have taken care of all of those. Now I can continue to focus on making this geometry better. So for every vertex that connects up here, I'm going to hit K and use the knife tool to cut across. So that way we make edge loops and dissolve the edges that we don't need anymore. So for example, this one, I'm going to take this, I'm going to cut across, and then I'm going to dissolve the edges. If it's not obvious already, it's much, much better to just simply model it for a game in the first place. Learn a software like 3ds Max or Blender. Even if Inventor is all you know, learn an actual 3D modeling package and just use that, because it'll make all this a lot easier. Okay, so I'm looking at this area right here, and I can see that this doesn't actually give our model a ton of shape, and it's a ton of useless geometry that isn't really gonna be appreciated in the end. So I'm just gonna hit X, delete faces, and then I'm going to select, or I'm going to dissolve these vertices, dissolve vertices, and just make this a triangle. And that just saved us a lot of work and has gotten rid of a lot of geometry. And again, if you look on the other side of this, you can see that there is a lot of geometry that is unnecessary. So, how am I going to get rid of this? I am going to select all these faces on the inside, and I'm going to delete those as well. This is geometry we don't need and is only going to make our job a lot harder. And again, is not going to be seen in the actual game, really, anyways. Well, it might be seen, but it sure as heck wouldn't be missed. And then I can take these... Hold on, let me look at the inside and make sure everything's cleaned up. So if I pull this out, I can merge these two, and now we're all sealed off. I can take these, and I can pull them out a little bit. And I can start sealing off this hole. So I'm going to hit K, make a knife tool, control, enter, and then seal that off. Perfect. This geometry is coming across very nicely. Actually, I will need a cut along here. And now, if everything worked correctly, actually, I'm going to dissolve this edge because I don't need it, and I'm going to dissolve one of these two edges. I'm going to dissolve this edge. Hold on. Actually, I'm going to dissolve neither edge. Let's see where those terminate. I'm going to make a knife down the middle. And then I'm going to dissolve both edges. may have been a little extra work, but it matches up to the actual geometry a little better. And then I'm going to cut right up like that. Dissolve these two edges and dissolve these two edges. And now you can see it matches up to our topology perfectly. And always be sure to save frequently, because doing all this work twice would be horrible. So now the geometry should mesh up, match up if I bridge this. And we get a few triangles, so obviously it doesn't. Let's see, so it's this edge loop right here, this edge loop right here, and a few others. So I'm going to dissolve those. Alright, there we go. Now the bridge worked perfectly. I'm going to save again. And we don't need this edge at all, actually, so I'm going to dissolve that too. Now I'm going to start working on this front part, because I'm just trying to work from the bottom up. So dissolve this vertice. Actually, yeah, I'm going to dissolve these two vertices, and then I'm going to dissolve this edge to make it a quad. Whoops. Okay, delete only edges and faces. There we go. Now we have a quad there. And I'm going to continue to just dissolve these edges. Delete edges and vertices. Face. Okay, so now we have this very long N-gon here that we're going to need to take care of. So in order to do that, I'm going to use a knife tool. And then I'm going to go all the way up to the top and make this a big quad. Just like that. And then I'm going to finish this bridge over here. And now we can continue to just dissolve our edges. And now we are at another part where it is going to be very messy. So because all this stuff on the right side of this mesh is flat, I'm going to do what we did before, select all of it, and then I'm going to delete it. But this curve up here, we're actually going to leave quite a few triangles just because it forms this sharp curve. So I'm going to not select any of the faces that border this curve. So I'm going to go down just like that. X, delete faces. And I'm going to do the same with the ones on the inside as well. Be sure to clean up any loose edges when you're deleting faces, because those will wreak havoc later. Like this, that I completely couldn't see because I was in edge select mode. So delete vertices. And then delete all these little tiny ones on the inside that, again, we are not even going to see, much less care about. And then we are going to do what we always do and simply clean up edges and vertices. Now we will be bridging these two, but it's easier to just add back in geometry later if we accidentally delete it than it is to constantly compare back and forth how much geometry is on one side, how much geometry is on the other, etc. Except on this one, I actually do know that there is matching geometry on the other side. So I need that edge loop to be there. I'm gonna make that a little cleaner. Control. I was hitting shift instead of control the first time I did it. X, dissolve edges. And thankfully I can just alt select that entire edge, dissolve it. Same thing with this one, dissolve it. Now I'm just going to bridge that back over. Alt, deselect the ones on the bottom and the ones on the top. Do that. W loop tools bridge, look for triangles. We want to clean this up so it doesn't look quite like triangles. Actually, now that I'm looking at it, I don't think this entire edge needs to even be there. So let's dissolve that edge. There we go. And we still need an edge loop up through here. So I'm going to place an edge loop. And then I'm going to dissolve this edge because I don't want it going up through the entire length of the mesh, because that means it'll be going up here at the end, and that's just messy, so it's better to just head it off in this big area right down here. So like I said, there's going to be some triangles. I'm just going to go over here and I'm going to merge this. So merge at last. That way the edge loop isn't going all the way up. And we're going to leave the triangle fans here because that actually forms the curve. I'm going to go through and I'm going to clean up these. And surprisingly, I'm just going to ignore this part with all the triangles. Except I am going to clip this off. That way we have a clear dividing point, which is this line right here, where we can stop ignoring the triangles. And I'm going to dissolve this edge as well, because we don't need that edge. And cut across here. There we go. And then we are going to simply start deleting faces again, like we all love to do. Delete all these ugly phantom edges. These phantom edges are a huge pain, and they will show up, especially if you have reflective materials. They will show up horribly in game engines. So pay extra attention trying to find those. And then everything above the triangle fan, we are going to go ahead and we are going to delete. And again, when we reach areas like this, where there is no edge, we have to use our imagination and see where the edge connects. And actually on this side, I'm going to leave most of these vertices. However, I'm going to use the knife tool to cut straight down like this. And then I'm actually going to leave these triangles because they're not that harmful and they actually do contribute a lot to the overall shape. Now I'm going to try and bridge, which this is going to be very unsuccessful the first time, I guarantee it. Okay, like I said, that was very, very unsuccessful. So it'd probably be helpful to quarantine this mesh off into two parts. So right here is going to be where we split it. So we're going to be bridging this bottom half and then the top half, but there is some kind of phantom geometry down here. Yep. Ooh, even some floating in midair. We haven't gotten many of those yet. Okay, so we can see up here, we're mainly fine at the bottom, but up at the top, there's a lot of extra geometry. So I'm trying to remember or memorize which ones I'm going to need to delete. So these two for sure. Dissolve edges. And then, let's see, every other one. 1, 2, 3. So let's just try bridging this. W loop tools bridge. And we have a few extra vertices, that's fine. Here I'm going to use the knife tool and cut right across like that, because we want this center part to be quads. These side parts don't necessarily have to be quads if we don't want them to. And now we are almost done. If we turn back on the mirror modifier, we have just a few more things left to do. Actually, let's turn back off the mirror modifier and patch this inner area. So to make it easy, I'm going to fill this area here just hit F, cap it off, and try to use the knife tool to sketch in some loose geometry or rough geometry. These two vertices can be merged. This is gonna be messy no matter how we try to do it, so I'm just gonna save myself the time and not really worry about it too much. Next, you're gonna select these edges, and then we are going to extrude them. And then I'm going to go in side view, go into Z wireframe, and I'm gonna drag these vertices to this line. So if I break out the grease pencil again and draw a line, I can, before all the vertices were lining up to this inner edge right here on the outside, or at least close enough to there where we can use that as a guide point. So I'm gonna drag them back on the x-axis until they meet up with that line. And then the last one, I'm gonna select these two vertices and merge at last. Before, I forgot to merge these two vertices, so W merge at last. I forgot to do that when we created the edge loop. Actually, I'm going to create another edge loop here. I'm gonna merge these two before I forget. And then I'm going to go like that. Now we have a huge edge loop going all the way down the center of the mesh. Now I'm going to go back into edge select, and I'm going to select all of these inner edges. Extrude on the x-axis. Merge the top one and the bottom one. So merge at last. Where's this one? And as before, we're gonna go hit Z to go into wireframe and simply match this to the inside curve. And make sure that last one matches up. And now we can do probably the easiest part of the entire model. And with, make sure you have clipping turned on. Hit Alt, select that edge, and then extrude on the, whoops, we want to make sure that this bottom edge is not selected. Extrude on the y-axis, make sure mirror is on. Extrude on the y-axis, and now everything should form together and make a straight edge. This one down here needs to be merged, so let's merge those two vertices. And we can see some areas here where it wasn't perfectly curved, so we can simply select these edges and smooth them out however we need to. I'm gonna turn off mirror again just so I can see it a little more clearly. And this isn't gonna be perfect, but when we smooth this mesh out, it's going to get rid of most of the stuff because this mesh is supposed to be shaded smooth. I'm just trying to get rid of most of the concave edges. And you can clean this up as much as you want to. I'm gonna leave it like this because this is just an example. but I'm going to continue to cap this area off. So I'm going to extrude this on the y-axis, making sure mirror is visible. So that way these two collide. Make a face cross there. And then for this one, I'm going to select all of the ones on one side except these top vertices, or these top edges. And you will see why in just a second. So now that these two curve together, I can take this, and with most of them quads, I can make these triangles. Because after all, we are just capping off a little tiny area, so it doesn't matter all that much. A, select everything, W, remove doubles. And this is going to remove any duplicate vertices that were not merged before. And then I'm going to take this inside edge, because this was flat before. I'm going to extrude on the y-axis, merge those, merge this with this. And as you can see, our mesh is coming together very quickly at the end. We still have this big inside edge, so I'm going to do that the same way I did before. Select the entire edge by Alt right clicking, and I'm going to deselect the ones at the top, extrude on the y-axis till they all merge. Let's see. Extrude that one too. And if I cut this one across, then that actually leaves a quad at the top, which is good. In fact, if we look at the back, so if I go back here, you can probably do the same thing. So on a second thought, I'm just going to delete these edges. And then see how I can make a quad. So there's one quad. There's another. And finally, there's our last quad. So that actually turns out pretty okay. Except there's something up here that's wrong. When in doubt, move the vertices around. Oh, there we go, that's why. So you can see when I move this vertice, there's a phantom edge there. So I'm gonna delete this vertice. Delete this edge that's right here. And then I'm going to re-extrude this. There we go. Now everything's good up there. And that just leaves us with this bottom area down here. So in order to turn this into actual geometry, I'm going to select this entire edge on the bottom and the entire edge on the outside and simply hit F. This will create a giant N-gon that we can then chop up later. And I'm going to do the same with the back vertices, or with the back face. Just select everything. And that one actually worked the first time, and hit F. And now we can use the knife tool and cut this up however we want. Now it's important that, for example, I'm going to make this cut right here, a big angle cut. It is important that once you cut, to not move these vertices around, because the reason we made the face is so that everything is planar. If we start moving vertices around, they're going to get jostled about, because this entire face isn't actually vertical. If we look at it from the side view, it's diagonal. But the knife will make it completely flat against the face. However, if I, again, make this cut, and then grab this vertice and move it down and go to the side view, you can see it is now inside the face, and we would need to bring it out like that later. So dissolve the vertice. Actually undo that. I'm actually going to start connecting the top to the bottom. So I'm going to cut like that. Make a cut like that. Normally you'd want to go from the inside or the outside in, the opposite way I'm doing this. But in this case, it would be more trouble than it's worth. And on the corner one here, we're not going to make a cut to that. We're just going to leave it. And for the last ones, we are going to start making a cut the opposite way. So instead of cutting down, because it's starting to get too skinny, we're going to start cutting across, leaving that one at the corner a quad. And then I'm going to make this cut like that. Make a loop cut on the bottom. It can connect it together. And I'm going to try my best to connect with the knife tool across two vertices on the left. Okay, I'm actually going to leave this one, make that a triangle. Dissolve this edge. And then connect these over. Move this edge down and start cutting across. And this one matches with that one. And we're really lucking out here. A lot of edges on the right side are matching up with edges on the left side. So this is saving us a ton of work. And let's see, how many do we need here? One, two. Actually, what happens if we dissolve this vertice? Okay, I'm gonna dissolve this vertice and just turn that into a triangle because we don't need it. Again, geometry that doesn't really contribute to the overall shape of it. And we need to save as much as possible. So how many vertices do I need here? I need 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I'm gonna hit Control R and then use the mouse wheel to scroll up and create 6 new edges. So 4, 5, 6. And then simply start cutting across with the knife tool. I'm going to turn this triangle into a quad. And then I'm going to do the same on the back. I'm going to start with the corners, or with the bevels, and 90 degree cuts to those. Find my inner edge. My inner quad is going to be here. And up here I have some extra geometry, dissolve edge. And here it's going to be this inner quad. And then simply start cutting over or down. As a matter of fact, I'm going to get rid of this edge loop as well, dissolve edges. And then turn this into a quad, or a triangle. And then I'm going to continue to work on this. Thank you. Okay, in this case, I'm gonna dissolve these edges again. Let's see. I'm gonna delete this edge. No, and I can't dissolve this edge. Let's see, dissolve edge. Okay, and I guess I'm gonna have to dissolve these edges as well. Nope, that doesn't help. Okay, so how can I do this? Because what I'm trying to do is, I ran out of edges, so I'm gonna try to connect this one to this one instead. And now can I dissolve the edge? Nope. Actually, I can dissolve the edge, and then I'm just going to make a new cut right here. And then dissolve this edge. There we go. That works perfectly. And there we go. Everything matches up perfectly. Awesome. And the problem with N-gons is sometimes when you get up into areas like this, the N-gon will actually overlap because the geometry is not perfect. So in that case, turn off limit selection to visible and just use the knife tool. And that should fix most of the N-gon issues. Actually, I'm going to delete this face because I think it can be done better. So this is not wanting to cooperate. Oh, I see why. Because it is a weird face. Whenever you have an inverse like this, or not an inverse, sorry, a concave edge, like this edge right here, faces aren't going to want to play nice with each other. So in that case, it's probably best to just use two triangles. Messes up our geometry a little bit, but I mean, in the end, it's kind of the best. And we need a few more edge loops in here, so add three more. Now I can easily see this one's gonna cut over to this one. Then we need another edge loop right in here. Cut over to that. These are gonna cut over to nothing in particular because they're way too far down to cut over to anything important. This one's gonna join to this one. And we need 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that. And there we go. There's our finished mesh. It could be a little cleaner, but I think we did a good job. I may have missed a spot or two, but on your own model, you can go and you can double check, because this tutorial's been long enough. I hope you enjoyed this video, and as always, I will see you next time.